the last time.
I'm very happy.
Well,
pleased to see you. Well, come in here. You have so many subjects.
Reports in the region. Do you have hard evidence that the Sandinistas have invaded Honduras? And if so, how concerned are you about that?
Well, obviously we're concerned, but yes, the information we have is that Nicaragua has crossed the border into Honduras.
Are you considering using U.S. troops, introducing them in combat, sir?
We've been in consultation with the Honduran government, but I can't comment on anything. No.
Do you know anything about a coup in Panama, Mr. President? Shots have been heard at the defense.
That's all we know either. Some shots have been heard. We've heard nothing else.
Are you giving up on the peace plan in view of Mr. Shamir's rejection and the continued killings in the occupied areas?
We have not yet had our meetings.
Well, you've heard of his rejection, though, haven't you?
Well, we're going to, I think, have a discussion on all these things.
Mr. President, thank you. Given the Robert McFarland's guilty plea last week and the impending indictments of Oliver North and John Poindexter, do you stand by your statement that you don't believe any laws were broken?
I have no knowledge of anything that was broken, and I am the one who gave all of you the first announcement of the discovery that there was extra money and so forth, because I only learned it after the covert operation was exposed by the press.
But why do you think no law was broken? Why do you think no law was broken if you found money that was improperly used, misappropriated?
Because from all of the investigation and everything else, we don't know where that money came from, and we don't know who had it, and we don't know where it went.
And you don't know that Oliver North handled it?
Thank you all.
Thank you. Do,
why do you think...
All I know was that we got the purchase price we had asked for.
Why do you think McFarland pleaded guilty, sir?
He just pleaded guilty to not telling Congress everything he wanted to know.
Well, don't you think that's
wrong? I do that myself. What?
You do that yourself?
No. Now, don't distort that. No. I just
mean, what did you mean, sir, so we understand what you mean?
Well, I just think Congress would like to do it. Be asking questions about almost everything.
Don't you think they should, in terms of the laws?
This is in the courts. Let's wait and determine whether they say the law.
Well, they've already said he pleaded guilty.
This one, please. Cameras?
What's here?
Cameras?
Remarks
about
the Schultz Initiative preclude any agreement that you could come to this meeting today?
Well, I'm not going to have you guess about that. We've always had a congenial relationship and looking forward to our talk.
Thank you.
This way. This way.
We're going
this way.
Comes at a pivotal time, and we believe there's a real chance to make progress toward peace. And we share with you the conviction that peace cannot be made under the threat of violence or terrorism. The PLO is once again revealing its true colors and its real intent. It says no to peace and yes to terrorism. And we're not going to give in to the PLO. Nor will we allow extremists in the Arab world to think that a wedge can be driven between the United States and Israel. Those who think that are wrong, and those who think that violence and terror will weaken us or the Israelis, the Israeli resolve, I think, are wrong. And so while proving them wrong, we must also search for ways to give moderate Palestinians and Arab governments a stake in becoming assertive. The developments in the territories may become more dangerous if met only by repressive measures, fueling even greater extremism and fundamentalism, not only in the territories, but in neighboring Arab states. And this could threaten the relative stability of the past few years. With the new weaponry in the Arab world and the evidence of fundamentalist power, we, I think, both want to avoid this sort of a regional threat to Israel. Political response is needed, and those in the Arab world who see the danger of continuing upheaval must see there's a basis for negotiating peace with Israel. This would serve their interests as well as managing the extremists. And that's what our initiative, I know, is all about. It satisfies nobody completely, but we think it meets everyone's essential needs and objectives. Yours in security and the need for transitional arrangements, and the Palestinians in terms of possibly gaining meaningful responsibility for self-rule. King Hussein's in terms of guaranteeing talks on final status and holding bilateral negotiations under an international umbrella. Egypt, we know, is supportive. And Hussein is interested, and the other Arabs are sympathetic, except for Syria. And we feel that there is some hope. And we've just discussed momentarily in the other room your problems with an international conference. Since you were here last February, we've said that we could accept such a conference if it makes direct bilateral negotiations possible. We also said we wouldn't go along with a conference that obstructed such negotiations. Our views haven't changed, and we'll not permit a conference that has the power to shape or to pass judgments or to dictate to the bilateral negotiations. Here I am. I know you've got an agenda of your own, and I'll quit talking. Come over here and turn it over to you.
Well, I have now to meet you again and discuss with you the situation in our area and the excellent relations between our two countries. I'm very proud to remind you that in the same place we have decided about establishing.
Yeah. part of the Kremlin. I want to give you something that the population really thinks. So he goes in the Red Square of the Bear and he sees this man, he said, "What do you think of Afghanistan?"
Fanaticism and brutality in that part of the world that is not current anywhere else. Look at the way the Iraqis and Iranians are blasting each other's cities. It's just senseless brutality.
Yeah. Yeah. And as I said, PLO, I made it a speech last night, which I said that PLO is, they're just terrorists. I'm dealing with that.
We've got the Muslim
fund. Help in Lebanon on certain things. Thank you, Tony.
They have a television there.
With a Christian Lebanese.
I'm not endorsing him, but I'm just telling you what he's doing.
I bet they do that.
What information do you have?
He has a television station in Europe.
Relationship between
Hezbollah in northern southern Lebanon.
Southern Lebanon.
He has the studios in Europe.
I don't think there's a direct relationship, but the Muslim Jihad and the Muslim holy warriors, which is what we have in the West Bank and Gaza, I think they get a lot of their inspiration from Khomeini.
But there are more and more Sunnis or coalition between the Hezbollah